What's up? Welcome to the stream. Hope you all had a good New Year party. If you're at partying or doing whatever you're doing, I like going for a hike sometimes on New Year's Day. That's fun. Now today I'm going to be attacking my Trello list. I've got 75 more cards I'd like to get done this week because this is just giving me anxiety how many cards are on here. So I'm like, this week I'm just really motivated. I just want to attack this entire thing and kill as many of these bugs as I can. Squash them. Jump on them. Make them splat. So I'm just going to go in order. Well, maybe not. Maybe I'll stick with some of these other ones. Yeah, let's do this one. Option to disable the low HP beep. Okay. Easy, man. That's going to be in interfaces. So I'll copy, I'm going to mimic this rumble options. It's very similar. We call this beep options. We got beep option 0, beep option 1. 0 is the default, just means that low HP beeps continues forever. 1 means it's limited, plays like 3 beeps and then and then it's done. Here we go, menu settings, rumble. Menu settings, beep. Low courage, low HP, I don't know, something like this. On or yeah, on will be fine. Call this one on and this one limited. Okay, let's see how this is looking. We need to get this option set up. It's gonna be like the rumble, which is in input. Yeah. However, let's see. Oh, I love this one shortcut in Vim, the pressing square bracket twice. That is a super sweet shortcut. Oh, it's going to be up here. Sound. All right, so we've got music volume, sound volume, and the low HP beep thing. So the key is going to be disable beep. And if we don't have it, it defaults to 0. And we do menu settings. All right, and the last thing we need to do is hook it up to the system. So where does it do that low HP thing? I think it's in. There it is, health system. Oh, which means we're going to need some kind of tracking for this. Maybe a static integer will do. Because we need to track, like, okay, limited means that it plays three beeps and then stops beeping. So we need to know that it's played three beeps. All right, we'll cut that. Should be a separate function for this. Yeah, let's make a little function for that. Wait, does it need any of these variables? Tick mod left. Ah, I think this is pretty good. All right, cool. So I'm making a little separate method for this just to self-contain all this code so I can like do something like this, like add a static integer, and it just kind of seems modular. Static int. Beep index equals 0. If eta health HP is greater than k life per container, then we're going to reset the beep index and return. Otherwise, we have low HP. We need to do something. Hey, what's up, Beeps? I'm doing good, man. How you doing? Make sure this is all still compiling. Fine. Good. Good to hear, man. How's your New Year's? Yeah, lots of tech stuff for sure. Call this, I'm making a static method to enable this. All right, so we'll have this method all hooked up. Nice, man. You had 16 people. Went bar hopping right on. Yeah, we had a party too. We were with some friends up in Tahoe, and it was good. There's a lot of people, lots of dancing. It was like a It was basically like a show. There was two stages. There was lots of champagne. It was a great time. Okay, one problem with this actually. Yeah, it definitely was fun. It was a good time. You know what? I just decided to make this an integer, and then I was like, wait a minute, maybe this should stay as a bool for now. I'm not gonna, yeah, for now it's a bool. What's up, Rocket? Am I on my New Year's hangover? No. Got that handled yesterday, man. Today's no more hangover. How about yourself, Rocket? What'd you do, man? Okay, so now we're gonna increase the beep index. And if the beep index here, if the low HP beep is not enabled and the beep index plus one is greater than or equal to three, then return. If it's possible to get a candy hangover, then I got one. I bet you did. Well, so I'm just fixing bugs today. I got 75 cards left. This list was at like 120, 111 or so last week. I'm already down to 75 cards, and my goal is to fix all 75 of these bugs this week. Oh man, back to school already? Wah, wah, wah. 75 bugs, let's do this. Let's do this. The stream title should be TCB. Why? What's TCB stand for? Let's do this. Okay, so we're gonna need low health. I got initial herb 2. We should put me at real low health right at first. Oh, taking care of business. Oh, I gotcha. I gotcha. It's CCB. I didn't know what it meant at all. Okay, we're low on health. Okay, let's put that to limited. Now it's not doing it at all. Oh, that's probably because it beeped 3 times already, though. Okay, so we would need... Why is it losing my context? Keeps losing the context, man. It's not cool, man. So we need to disable the beep index, which means we need to make the beep index a static global. Did I just say that out loud? I'm like using a static global? Yes, kids, that's right. I'm using a static global. And it's okay. You can do stuff like this. All right, let's see if it worked. It should have been, yep, it gave us disable beep. Very good. Okay, so let's make a couple more checks to make sure this is working as it should. Your school's weird. Oh, because of the kids. Ah, I hear you, man. I hear you. There are some weird kids in schools. Oh, you do? Oh, man. Sorry to hear that, man. Didn't start over. Yeah, there you go. Big. Please, parents. Ahoy, salad. One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four, five. This thing's not working at all. Hold on, is this even... the right function? Did I check that other stuff out? Nice, right on. I know, right? Just to get this far, 120 down to 75. Thanks, man. What's up, Arcane? Howdy, both y'alls. What's up, mans? What's up, mans? Yeah, okay, we're low on health and it's not doing anything now. And it should have disabled beep zero. Good. Okay, so it is this method. Why is this not? You earned the name Rich Shit because you got a good amount of stuff. Oh, they're making up. Last Christmas wasn't so good, huh? I'm kind of baffled. I'm baffled. That should work. Oh, it's not setting it. So, where is that? Game.cpp. So, when you set up the settings and stuff. It's kind of like this function right here. So this is health system. Enable low HP beep. That should help. Salad, how was your New Year's, man? How was it? No more beeps. So sad. It should have reset the beep index, though. But now, if I start the game, it should start with the right beep. Whoa, right on. Got the fancy neighbor was shooting off fireworks. Cool. Right on, that sounds fun. Fireworks. Still nothing. Nothing at all. All right, it's time to debug this. Let's make sure that's right, and this is all going well. Okay, we're getting this call. It should be from the very beginning. Yep, light and learn, load settings, not get bool, disable beep. What is disable beep right now? Zero? Steve is one. Okay, so we should be getting enable low HP beep false. Good, and that's what it is. And we're resetting the beep index. Yeah, you got a new desk right on. Oh, I always feel like that too. I'll probably keep calling it 2016 for at least the next month. But by February, I better be calling it 2017, or else. So the beep index is 0. I see what's going on. The beep index is incrementing every time it calls this function, not every time it beeps. So we need to turn the beep to this. And the rest of this function too. We can turn this into a const bool. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, we're all in the same boat. None of us can admit that it's 2017 yet. This can't be 2017. It was like just 2016 a minute ago. So we'll go if do beep. Actually, no, we can just go if do beep here, and we can just keep increasing the beep index. And this one, we always want to do this enums hurt thing. But the rumble is also if do beep. It's below 0. Yeah, it could snow. Arizona, I don't know that number. I don't know this number. I'm ignoring the call. Ring, ring, ring. It reminds me of Toe Jam and Earl. Have you played Toe Jam and Earl, Rocket Bunny? Ring, ring, ring. Oh, whoops. Okay, that's supposed to be do beep is if low HP enabled, or the beep index is less than 3. Such a strange game. You gotta try it, Rocket Bunny. The original Toe Jam and Earl. Ultimate classic. In Toe Jam and Earl, there's this thing where you can get a telephone, and it like opens up part of your map. I watched a regular show. There's nothing regular about it. Isn't that funny? Right? That's one of my favorite shows. I love regular show. Oh, good. Okay, we still got the red corners. And if we change the setting, enables it. Three. Yes! It's like 5, 4. Yes. All right, cool. One thing done. That's a bug. Done. A done bug, yeah. It's not to be done. It's done. What the hell? Arizona number? Arizona number, call me again. It's probably somebody I know now. That wasn't really a bug. It was more just an option to disable low HP beep and rumble after 3 times repeated. Oh, I should check, I guess. I should check the controller. Make sure the rumble is disabled after 3. Yeah. So yeah, it just disables it when it's beeped for a while as an option for people that annoys them. One of the things on my list to do. On a good day, I can get maybe 20 of these Trello items done. That's like a great day, actually. Rumble, rumble, rumble. No more rumble. Good. Rumble, 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 rumble. Good, still rumbling. Limited. 1, 2, 3. Cool. Okay, good. I'm gonna leave it on though, because I like it on personally. Okay, that's confirmed. Let's turn off the initial hurt so that it doesn't scare the shit out of me next time I run it. And check this in. So we added some new strings, the low HP beep thing. We call it when the game loads. Today we're gonna take a break from Spanish. Oh no! Did she actually teach you Dutch? Or not you, but did she teach the other students Dutch? Your one advantage, man. Oh, what are you gonna do if everybody learns Dutch? Trust me, they won't learn Dutch. Disable beep, menu settings, beep. Disable beep, disable beep. Whoops, oh, I did the wrong settings. Damn polyglots. Even though K beep options and K rumble options were exactly the same, that's why that worked. All right, there we go. And after triple checking everything, it all still looks good. America's changing the music you like? What? This can't be possible. Boom, one more bug off the list. Bug/feature. Okay, so I'm gonna be right back. Yeah, you listening to country western, eating barbecue, shopping at Walmart while wearing a cowboy hat? Be right back. You able to link whatever you want? Yes, go right ahead. Share your public Spotify playlist. Right, so let's find another easy one to do here. Oh, this should be a pretty simple one. Zero took my sword again. So there's this story element that can play right after another story element, which shouldn't happen. Okay, so let's copy back up the saves file. And then I'm gonna take my trailers, beta, scenes, OX, meditate. Okay, so zero took my sword again. Can happen right after gaining the meditate skill. Right after gaining meditate? Let's make sure I have. Swordless 10, all right. Swordless 10, I already did Swordless 10. And we need to not have the meditate. Okay, so I got meditate. He disappears, and yes, it does do. Zero took my sword again. Okay, so that's... Just need to look at the story element for Zero took my sword again. Swordless 10. Dude, where's my sword? I don't know, dude. Where's your sword? Daft Punk? Okay, so this is Z3 through 9. Well, just make it Z4 through 9. That'll start to make it better. But also, you have to have the meditate. Flag swordless and flag home. Or entrance. Has to have the entrance flag. And Z4 through 9. This is going to be a super easy one. So if I run it now. Dude, where's my sword? You can't decide. Well, I would encourage you to look at your reasons for why you are considering both options. Why are you considering web dev? Be really, really honest with yourself, right? Why are you considering making games? Be really, really honest with yourself. Okay, I think that worked. Let's check it one more time. This time I'm not going to use the meditate skill. Okay, That's good, because last time it happened right away. Good to know. Okay, so now I just need to go to the other swordless dungeon with this saves file, which could be anywhere. Could be dungeon four. It's probably not dungeon four. Let's guess six. Could be anywhere from four to nine. Right, there you go. You get to experiment with both. So what I was trying to, my point I was trying to make there was sometimes you're wanting to make a life choice. Like, life choices are really important things, right? You're going to be going down a path that will last for years, man. Oh, cool. So wait, what you want to do web dev because it's kind of cool, and you can make a decent amount of money, right? And for Java, I just like to make games. I personally, Java seems like the easiest. Well, man, how can I put this? Like making these big choices, like this is a huge choice because it will affect your life for years and years. And sometimes you make these big life choices because of what you think will happen in the future. Like you think that, oh, if I do web dev, I'll make a decent amount of money. Okay. But you got to assume that that's we got to admit that that's an assumption. You might not necessarily make a lot of money doing web dev. You might not make any money doing web dev. Who knows, right? You probably will, but I'm just saying that that's an assumption, right? And also, you're assuming another thing about yourself where it comes to making games. You're assuming that you're bad at finishing them. And I bet you have another assumption in there that you're not going to make much money from games. Which also both of those things are also assumptions, right? You might make a killing making video games, or it might be just as you think, and you might not make any money making video games. You might actually find that you break through in some way and you're able to finish all the projects you ever start, or you may just continue on the way you were. It's all kind of depending on you, man. What's your heart say? I would definitely encourage you to not make decisions solely based on what you think what your head says about things. You know what I mean? Your head says, "Oh, I can make money doing this, and I'm not going to make money doing that." Your head says, "Oh, I'm not going to be able to do that because I can't finish it, or I'm going to be able to do this because it's easy," right? And both those things are head things. You got to consider what your heart has to say about it all, as well as your head. So well, there you go. You know yourself better than anybody. All I'm saying is just search your soul a minute before you make this choice. And just be brutally honest with yourself about what you want. Yeah, good point, Salad. It does. Making fun games is not just something you start out of the gates just doing. In fact, when it comes to just about everything you do, you're never going to be that great of it at first. Like making music, you're going to probably suck at making music at first. I did. Or video games, or having sex, or kissing a girl, or kissing a boy, whatever, kissing people. These things take time and practice. You're not just going to be great at it at first. Okay, wrong dungeon again. There you go. Other than sex and kissing, I was born a master at both. Nice. Nice. Guessing dungeons here. Ah, here we go. And we should get the quote, Zero took my sword. Oh wait, no, I need to have the meditate skill for that to happen. Oh, and this is 60 FPS, no wonder it's doing what it's doing. So there you go in the barrel, right? Good. Yeah, learning to do it for the journey. Yeah. In addition to the destination. I like the way you put that, Salad. I really like the way you put that. You said in addition to the destination. Because there's joy in both, right? You can enjoy getting to a destination. You can enjoy the journey. And the common saying is, it's not the destination, it's the journey. But that's ruling out the joy of getting to the destination. So it's definitely both. Yeah, right? If you enjoy failing and getting better as a result, then that's the kind of thing you're going to love doing. And that's kind of why I fell into doing video games, because I loved sucking at it at first. I loved it anyway. Okay, one more bug fixed. Yeah, definitely, definitely. It's nice. It's a nice thing to just take that step back and go, yeah, look how far I've come. Look what I did. Okay, one more bug fixed. Oh, this might be an easy one to cross off the list here. You love programming. The destination is always the last cherry on top. Mmm. That's cool. I'm glad you like programming so much. That's cool, man. Okay, let's check this out. I think this is already fixed. Cheese 362. Yes, you did, right? You're putting in some really good ways here. I like that. Mega Seed Cheese. Dungeon. What was it? 3-3-6? 3-6. 3-6-2. All right. Hi, hamster. Okay, so this room took a second for the chest to enable after all the enemies died, and I did fix a bug recently about that, so hopefully, yeah, it enabled right away. Cool. Okay, well, I'm gonna try this over and over a few times to see if I can get it to happen again. Like, for starters, we'll start in the room right below it. Just fixing bugs, man. I got 2 bugs fixed already. I'm down to 73 bugs to do this week. Good guess. This time I'll fight the enemies. Good. The chest enabled right after it happened. Pretty sure this bug is fixed. Let's try it one more time. At least. Yeah. Thank you. last time. So how could I get this to maybe mess up somehow? I could throw my top hat right after everybody, or before everybody dies. Oh, I could try and make him die. Die with his, Hornerang thing flying out in the air. That would probably work. Okay, throw your thing, kill him. And good. So the bug that was happening there earlier was that the Hornerang, his horn thing that he throws, is actually considered an enemy. So when he died, the horn was still in the air. And so this chest didn't activate because the game thought there was still an enemy in the room, but I fixed the whole issue with the horn. Wagus, what's up, man? Long time no see. How you been, man? Okay, so that's confirmed. Another bug off the list. Down to 72 cards. Lightning boss. Oh, this is a pretty easy one. Lightning boss easies, random strikes. Common game libraries used in C++. There is SDL. There is SFML. I think SFML is C++. There is Cocos 2DX. There is Unreal. Those are some common ones. Okay, so the lightning boss easy. First of all, we'll delete this, delete that, go to dungeon 10. And we need to go find the lightning boss easy. Ogre, oh, that's a good idea. What's my choice for 2D? My choice for 2D, well, my choice is Cocos 2DX because I'm so familiar with it, but I have recently tried SDL and I really liked SDL. SDL is pretty cool. It might not have everything I need to make this game, but I would consider using it even just to like, manually do the things that it can't do, like shader. I'm not sure if it can do shaders or what, but anyways, SDL is pretty good. Cocos 2DX is great. Well, Cocos 2DX is kind of bloated, but still really good. SFML, I haven't tried. Vegas, when will the game be released? I don't know yet, man. I don't know. I got a video about it, though. Let me get you the video. Hey, what's up? Welcome. No, it's not very close. I know I'm fixing bugs, but I've been doing this continuously throughout the entire project because it's kind of a, I'm almost publicly developing it in the sense that I'm releasing beta updates every single week. Oh, okay, so they can't do shader. Maybe that's why it didn't work when I tried to test it. Okay, so lightning boss easy. Let's go find one of those. Oh, here we go. Yeah, see that? She's like, her lightning strikes are just super random. Why the hell is that? Yeah. Okay. Let's open up that. That's Lightning Boss. Easy. And I'll look at her different sequences. She has the initial two. Initial two is where she becomes visible. Here's her mode to remove. Here's where she attacks by setting a vector towards you. Here's where she stops attacking, update attacking, lightning. Here we go. Category any, timer less than zero, target any, select sequence. Mode of frequency, face target, spawn lightning foe. Spawn lightning foe, spawn lightning foe. Oh, that's how it's meant to be. She doesn't do this spiral thing. And that makes a lot of sense. Because the spiral, the whole spirally lightning, that's kind of meant to be for the boss. This is the kind of the before boss instance of her. Okay, that makes sense now. Let's look at the lightning boss proper. See, she spawns a lightning spiral. So, okay, this all makes sense now. But this doesn't. Oh, actually, it does. Because that's what makes it look right. Okay, let's do this again. This isn't even a bug. I thought it was a bug, but it wasn't. Glad this is such an easy one. Okay, so she's just going to randomly spawn lightning strikes. Why isn't she moving now? Looks like she got stuck there in the corner somehow. Yeah, so far it's been a pretty easy bug fix. It wasn't even a bug! She's stuck again? What are you doing? Oh, there. She is kind of boring, though, while she's just sitting there. So she has lightning and then sets mode one after lightning, so. Why isn't she attempting an attack? Oh, because attack only happens in mode zero. Yeah, I may do that. So the first thing I want to do is for her to attack you more often. She's kind of getting stuck in this. She's getting stuck because she gets into mode one right after she does the lightning. And oh, because she's meant to disappear. So if mode one of category any, she doesn't drop bombs. It Don't need that one. Just need to make it a little more likely that she'll do this. Hey, what's up, Beach Knee? How's it going, man? Had CMake generate next code? One of the files? Whoa. Beach Knee, how was your New Year's? Happy New Year to you, too. Happy New Year, 2017. She's still stuck. Why are you stuck? There we go. She disappeared. Can't complain, it was awesome. Right on. How's the game coming, man? What you been working on? What you been drawing? Still not disappearing. Nice. You made progress? Good to hear. Yay, show me something. Yeah. So she does this timer 4 to 5 seconds here, and then. And then she waits. Oh, she waits the entire time. So let's say if timer is less than 3 seconds. Just wanted to attack you a little more often, a little more intimidating. There we go. Now she's really disappearing a lot. And that puts her back in her zero mode so she can do more stuff. Awesome. This is a lot more fun. Oh, nice, man. Look at that. That's beautiful. It's like an archangel. Oh, this looks like a sweet animation, man. Is that the hero or is that one of the enemies? Dude, awesome. Yeah, cool. Look at these enemies. I love the stone face. Whoa, that spider. Is that a spider with a lion's head? What is that? That's scary. Yeah, this is a cool shot too. This like back silhouette with these sunbeams. In a forest? I like it. Oh, that's the protagonist. Wow, dude. Nice progress, man. Okay, that's good. Oh, it's an ant spider. Whoa. Scary. All right, down to 71 cards. We're almost about to break 70 down to 60s. I'm looking for easy ones. Easy ones I can finish quickly. Oh, when you purchase an item, the light's fading on the button doesn't line up. That's pretty easy. Yay, right on. Oh yeah, you gotta play it. That's right. How'd it go? We need to put the location. It's one of the stores. Right on. You like that? Cool. There'll be more of that going on. Yeah, right on. So I wanted to purchase something that I couldn't get. Nice, cool. Glad you like the soundtrack. So, okay, that fade just needs to happen faster. Where is that? Is it input system? Gear system? I think it might be gear system. You did? Oh, that's cool. I'm glad to hear that. I can't wait to work on more music. There's going to be more procedural tunes. Yep, it's the strong stuff. I think it's gear system. Yeah, it's in here. You purchase an item. Oh, here it is. Anim's purchase item. Depress the switch, retract the wall jutting. The item falls on the player, remove the sprites. Here it is. Wait, is it this one? Yeah, he's a space hippie. Yeah. Awesome, man. How far did you make it? I guess it's this one, this glow sprite. Let's see what happens if I. Tint it. Yes, right? Man pages. Oh. You know what I've been wondering about man pages? Can you actually jump to, like, you know how at the end of a man page it tells you, like, suggested other things that are related to this thing you're looking up? Is there some way to jump to those? Oh, cool. You're now just cleared the side quest. Nice. Right on. Okay, so I'm gonna get here. Can't purchase that. Yeah, so that wasn't it. Okay, I'm looking for whatever this. That's the item switch, item sprite. I thought it was the glow sprite. No, that's funny. Like I've been asked that before. Like, is Rock me as a character? And yes, in a way, he kind of is, but I'm trying to make it so he's not more and more. When I first started Songbringer, I had this feeling that like, okay, what's the most vulnerable thing I can do is to put myself in a video game, because then I'm like, I have to put my own flaws in the video game. So I guess I kind of have done that a lot. I've always like modeled Rock's dialogue after what I would say in a certain situation, and he kind of looks like me. But I'm trying to make it more and more so he's not. Like, I would think of Rock as like maybe like some ancient forebear of mine, like 10,000 years ago or something. It's Captain Tusk. Right? Captain Tusk is who is just somebody I wanted to make a character that's really eloquent. 'Cause you don't really see that much in video. Well, I guess you've seen it in a few video games. Sword and Sorcery was really eloquent. Well, most of the time, right? Which one of these damn sprites is the one sprite that I need to turn off for this? Area.cpp. I think let's create item. Create items. Purchasable. Here it is. Okay. Create the wall jet above, the item sprite above, the glow sprite. Isn't this the glow sprite? K tag second. Oh, yeah. Shakespeare, so eloquent. Kind of disabled a lot. But I think that was the sprite. Said visible false. K tag second. Get item switch glow sprite. Gets the item switch. And then gets the second child by tag. glow sprite, item sprite, info layer. You fried your Arduino? Oh no. Lacking much? Lacking much? Yes, yes it is. So I think what's happening is it's purchasing the item. It's stopping all the actions for the glow, but then it So I need some way to indicate that or to know that the item switches, the items aren't even purchased. What if it just phases to zero as quick as possible? Still fades out. It's as if this action isn't even happening, which means it's probably doing. Oh, if glow sprite is visible is not equal to selected. A public IB school. What's a public IB school? Okay, let's figure out what's causing all this to happen. This is in show item info. And I think this is what's happening is it's triggering that, but we can't do it quite yet. Oh, a public school with a European curriculum. Cool. Dan Hyper, are you a bot? Are you a bot or are you just hyper? All right, glow sprite. Yeah, okay, we got this. Let's turn on this other breakpoint. So it stops all the actions for the glow sprite. And then runs this action. Thing. Weird. Okay, so it wasn't what I thought. What is causing it to not to fade so slow? Tsunagi sound meme. So it didn't get there unless the breakpoint didn't work. It had to have been the breakpoint. I don't trust you right now, Xcode. I'm closing Xcode, reopening it, because I've seen it miss my breakpoints before. Okay, so turn on that one. Turn on this one. Still nothing. All right, wait, what if we take take away the tag so it can't be found again. Oh, wait a minute. Is it even getting in here? I didn't even step into this method. Could be that. Might just want to be getting into that call there. Like the index might be wrong. Why would the index be wrong though? So the index is 2. That sounds right. 0, 1, 2. It's got the glow sprite. Okay, so we're stopping all actions. Setting the tag 0. Okay, so it is doing this. Okay, let's see if it worked. It did! It worked! I don't know what was causing it to do its glow to slowly fade out, but something was. So if I set the tag to 0, I should probably do this to the info layer too. No, that might ruin it. Okay, let's make that fade a little slower just to see. So I'm just determining now what's the right amount of time for this fade out to for it to look right. Ugh. Mm-hmm. That half a second is actually all right. I was concerned about the glow part on top of the switch. Oh, it does look weird if you focus on just that. You gonna start making packages of art to sell on game agent asset stores? Awesome, man. Cool. Yeah. Theme packs. Make it easy for them to get on their game engine. That's better. Okay, so it fades out quicker. Such a tiny little thing, but it's was one thing on my list to do. Yeah, and you get to build up some good practice doing that too. All right, we're down to 70 cards. Next one's gonna make it 69. This shouldn't be too hard here. Plot zoom plus equipment menu zoom. So, oh, we can actually continue from right there, negative three. These asset stores list me an interesting phenomenon. So, yeah, stock prefabs showing up in games. What's a notable example? Have you noticed? Okay, so if I'm right here, and I don't have level one. Let's find level one. Here's level one. Delete a word. Delete a word. So it'll zoom in, and then I'll use the equipment menu, and it will look weird. See that? It's like, what? That shouldn't be too hard to fix. You're watching someone play a new horror game? A house that was clearly a prefab? Oh. It's a horror game about Furbies? Oh. So it would have to be phase gear. I think there's already something about it zooming. Yeah, it does a lens slide. It goes from V3F unit Z to... Oh, I think what it needs to do is lens clear effects. Clear temporary effects. Oh, I hope it's this easy. This would be the quickest bug fix of today's bug fixing. Nice. Oh, it still did the zoom out though. What's happening is there's some temporary. There's like all the lens effects are additive. Furby's notorious. Yeah, because they never shut up. It's a mechanic. Ah, nice. That's a funny. That's so great. Okay, so the story thing is the level one. Oops. It does lens zoom. That's it. Just lens zoom. So it's an action zoom or action lens. Anim's zoom in on. Okay, so this anim's zoom in on needs to be a little smarter. If the camera has been changed since it was last called, this basically this last bit right here, it is lens zoom dimmer, zoom duration, new camera to unit Z. Actually, new camera needs to be whatever the camera is. Okay, stream later. Have a good one. So we're not gonna need this stuff, and we'll need to get the current lens pause. I think the get camera pause, maybe inside pause. One of those pauses. So I'll let it run this time just to see if it actually still works with it zooming in and then zooming back out with the same. Nope. Okay, so that broke it. Maybe it's inside pause. I think this is supposed to be modifying the outside though. Lens zoom. Nope. So we got old camera to new camera. Lens zoom. Take a look at this. What is this? This is modifying. That's modifying the outside camera. So what's get camera? Get camera pause. That's Cam's final dot outside. What's up, Kobarney? Holidays, are you on a holiday? Our holiday's kind of over now here. Maybe I need to get these other ones. Well, I guess I could see what would actually need to be. Hold on, what would it have to be? Auto P, get inside camera pause. So if get inside camera pause returned cams base dot outside, maybe it would work. Red baggage. Oh, this is my drum kit. This thing? My drums, man. So did it work? I think it might have actually worked. Yeah, I set it up. So the case is actually the bass drum. And then my drum throne is there where I sit on to actually work. Oh, it did work. It zoomed out right. Yay! So we just need to add that function. I'm a total hippie. I am. Give me that. Yep. There's that. My kick pedal. It's still got Burning Man dust on it. Do you see that? Look at this. That is playa dust right there. That white powdery dust. Straight from Burning Man. Hippie Fest. Yeah, right. Totally. Yeah, the case is the bass drum. Exactly. So I set it up, right? I take everything out of there, and all it has is a snare drum, the bass drum, which is the suitcase, and a hi-hat. The hi-hat doesn't fit in it, though. So the hi-hat has to stay outside. But I do have my hi-hat cymbals in there. And drumsticks and snare stand and everything. Everything fits in there except for the hi-hat, basically. So it's I love it, man. I love it. And I'm actually going to saw a hole in it. I really want to get another a floor tom and then saw a hole, a circular hole, and then mount the floor tom head on there. So it'll make it'll actually make a sound kind of a lot closer to a real bass drum. Right now it sounds like you're just hitting a piece of suitcase. Yeah, it's by design, and it's not my design. I've seen it. There's several other people that have done this on the internet, and there's like instructions on how to make your own. But I just love it because, as opposed to my last drum set I had wouldn't fit, you know, in this room or whatever. It would fit in this room, but like everything else wouldn't fit in the room if I put it in here because it's just too. It takes a lot of room. But this is sweet because it's all compact. Yeah, lots of instruments. So I got guitars on the wall too. I don't know if you can see these. But all my guitars are hanging on the wall over here. And I got my other electric guitar. This thing you can't hear, but it's super custom. It's like a video game guitar.
practically. But it's got really good pickups and stuff. And I also got a bass guitar over here. And this is what I make my drums with electronically. It's a little drum pad thing. Also doubles as a laptop stand.
It's really compact, yeah. It all compacts into that one little suitcase. Yeah, I am, right, Ishni? I am. I'm completely a one-man band. Advantages and disadvantages. Definitely both. Okay, so we need some functions to get the base cameras. B3F get base camera pause. And base inside camera pause. Oh wait, this is the base outside final. You try to find some wooden handles on a wall for a guitar? Oh, yeah? Oh, one thing I use sometimes when I can't find guitar handles is you can actually get those hooks. They're like shaped like this, and then the bottom of the hook is a screw. And you can use those for guitars. They just, you just have to have the right guitar head for it, you know, to fit in it. But so you can pretty much kind of make your own. Don't necessarily need to have those things. Gosh, these things, these are like $5 here in the United States, though, for hanging guitars. They're pretty cheap. All right, so we need to hook those methods up. Get base camera pause. I'm too lazy and it's minus 15 outside. Oh man, minus 15. Dang, that's cold. I'm a total wuss when it comes to temperatures. I hate cold temperatures. So wait, was that base outside? I think it's base camera pause. Yeah, wow. Minus 15? Ouch. Wait, is that like R0? It's like around R0. It's cold. We were just up in the cold. We were up in Lake Tahoe, which is pretty cold. It was like minus 5 or 10. Oh no, and it's too hot outside in the summer? Yes, it zoomed right. Okay, so now if I go and run it, this time interrupt it by going to the gear menu, it should be okay. Okay, interrupt. Gear menu looks fine. Go back. And good. Good, good, good. Let's see that once more. This time. We'll set a breakpoint right here. This is in a function called anim zoom in on. Tahoe gets nippy, man. I was a nippy hippie. Okay, I just want to see this bit right here. Set a breakpoint there just to make sure that actually did re-engage the whole lens zoom and it just didn't zoom any because it was already zoomed out. So if I get this one fixed, that means I'll fix 5 bugs on today's stream. That's a lot of bugs. Okay, zoomed in. Menu. Looks all right. Exit the menu. Sweet. We got the breakpoint. Xcode keeps doing this weird stuff where it doesn't show me what line it's on. Okay, so the position of the outside camera. Sometimes it's not cold at minus 25. Sometimes you stop feeling your hands at minus 5. That is weird. Okay, so the base camera pause was already 001. So this is just, in effect, doing nothing. So we might as well add this here. If P is not equal to V3F unit Z. Then push the effect. It's pure magic. The weather's magic. It changes on you. Sometimes it's minus 5 and feels okay. Sometimes it's minus 25 and feels okay still. I hear you on that. It's kind of like that here. Sometimes it's like minus, sometimes it's, well, like positive something. Like your, what would be your like plus 10 and it feels cold. Okay, good. That zoom in and zoom out worked fine. And then I'm just going to test it one last time. Go into the menu. Oh, wait. Let's try and mess it up. Like, we'll pause. Unpause. Go to the gear menu. Rebind something. Good. Okay, it was fine. And last time, we'll just make sure that it works. As it's supposed to, but this time we'll walk in from off screen. Okay, that worked. I just got some bit of curiosity here though. What happens if I walk off the screen? I don't know if I've checked that before. So it's happening. I walk off screen. Oh, it just zoomed back out. Okay, that's fine. Alright, cool. Bug fixed. Yay! Yay! So basically what happened here is the zoom out for this whole zoom in on thing. The zoom out happens to use the camera's current position rather than just what it's thought its old position would be. And then also when you start the phase gear, it clears any temporary effects so that it works as intended. Yeah, you're done cleaning your hamster's cage? What a lucky hamster. Hey, that's cool. Look, he's got his own little world. Is he the white? Oh, wait, I see him. He's like, hey, what's up, Rocket Bunny? How you doing, Rocket Bunny? He like, look at this man. He lives on popcorn. He can just eat his floor. He's got a lot of energy. I know it's not popcorn. I know it's not popcorn, but it looked like popcorn in the picture. And it just seemed like a great thing for a hamster to live on popcorn. If I were a hamster, I'd be like, yes! I can wake up, it's so soft, it's such a nice like thing to sleep on. And the popcorn kernel works perfectly as a pillow, and then I can eat it. It'd be great. Wait, from level or any zoom in on. No flash photography, please. What's up, Cropper? Oh, yeah, I know, right? It's hamsters eating too much. Okay, it's time to take another one off the list. Boom. Yes, I'm down to 69 cards. Oh. Can I get one more done today, you think? What do we got? This is already 2 hours in. Is there anything that's super fast, like guaranteed fast? I guess I can start doing this one. This one might be really fast. Might be not fast, but let's check it out. And that'll be it for today's stream after I do this. You had a hamster? He fell from the ceiling. And he still lived 6 years? Whoa! Dude, your hamster has 9 lives. Dungeon 6. Two areas south. Oh, he's a dwarf hamster. Spider hamster. Ah. Wait, is it? Hold on. Where was this? Two areas south of the Verloc. Gotta find it. Where's the Verloc? Hello, have you seen a Verloc anywhere? Thank you, please. Your mom thought you bought 2 new ones? Just so she wouldn't be upset? Oh, your mom, she has a nice heart, doesn't she? Here it is. What? Two rooms south of the Verloc, that would be this, the entrance room. Oh, this might be old. Well, the one place where it would actually put a Verloc, a gate, would be the room that goes into, ooh, this is a cool room. You could never have a pet with a short lifespan. You're feeling, I know, feelings, right? It's tough. It's hard as balls. Do you die 5 times in your first dungeon? Oh man, I didn't know it was that hard. I don't want it to be too hard. Maybe there should be some more health or something in the first dungeon. What do you think? Should there be? Did I go to the right dungeon? Here it is. Here's where it would be. So now it's using an acid gate. I think this is okay. This is appropriate. This is an old, old, old bug. It's just things have changed since then. archiving it. Yes, 68 bugs. Starting today at 75? 77? I don't know. You know, don't change a thing. It's just right. Okay, all right. Good to hear, good to hear. Well, that's it for today, guys. We got six freaking bugs fixed. I think six. I don't know. Maybe more. That's awesome for one stream. So, yeah, that's my goal this week. I'm trying to get all of these bugs on my now list. These are bugs and features, not all bugs. But all these things I want to get done this week. And that's of course, not going to happen. Probably not. So, but anyways, I'll see you guys next time. Hope you all are having a great 2017 so far, even though I've refused to acknowledge that it is 2017 officially until at least February. See you guys.